Now there are different temperature scales in order to measure temperature. So out of that, the common scales are degree Celsius, degree Fahrenheit and Kelvin. So you know that they are actually divided into different parts, equal parts, and moreover there is an upper fixed point and a lower fixed point on each thermometer scale. And you know that what is a lower fixed point? Lower fixed point is a point at which ice melts, and upper fixed point is a point at which water boils. Same for degree Celsius, same for degree Fahrenheit, same for Kelvin. So we are just going to see that into how many equal parts they are actually divided. So if we talk about degree Celsius, the lower fixed temperature is 0 degree Celsius and upper fixed point is 100 degree Celsius. It is actually divided equally into 100 parts. So the temperature, the lower fixed point at which ice melt is 0 degree Celsius, and on Celsius scale the upper fixed point at which water boil is the 100 degree Celsius. Same for in Fahrenheit, like in Fahrenheit what we have, it is 32 degree Fahrenheit is the lower fixed point and 212 degree Fahrenheit is the upper fixed point, that is at which the ice melts and this is at what the water boils, and it is actually divided equally into 180 parts. And if we look for the Kelvin, the lower fixed point is 273, lower fixed point or lower fixed temperature at which the ice melts, and the upper fixed point is 373 Kelvin. So again it is divided into 100 parts. So these are the temperature scales. You need to remember the lower fixed point and the upper fixed point on all of these scales. And you know that we can actually convert the temperature on one temperature scale to another. Suppose if you wish to convert degree Celsius into Fahrenheit, then what formula you will be using? You will be using this one. C upon 5 is equal to F minus 32 upon 9. Suppose if you have temperature 100 degrees Celsius and you need to convert into Fahrenheit, so how you will be doing that? You will be doing that 100 upon 5 is equal to F minus 32 upon 9, comes out to be 900 upon 5 is equal to F minus 32, or if you solve for it, 5 under 5, it comes out to be 180. So it is 180 plus 32 is equal to Fahrenheit, because this comes here, it becomes plus. So it comes out to be 212 Fahrenheit. Again, you know that 100 is the upper fixed point and upper fixed point on the Fahrenheit is 212. So it's same answer, 212 degree Fahrenheit. So if you get a question like this, let us find out that at what temperature the reading on the degree Celsius and Fahrenheit is going to be same. So how you will be doing that? You will consider temperature as x, putting in it you have x upon 5, x minus 32 upon 9, because we are taking temperature on Celsius and Fahrenheit both at x. Suppose we say that at temperature x they both are equal, so I have taken x, so it if I solve it, it becomes 9x is equal to 5x minus 32, 9x is equal to 5x plus, sorry, minus 5 to the 10th, 160. So 9x minus 5x is equal to minus 160. So this is how you're going to solve for it. So that means at this temperature, it is going to be equal. I think you can solve it. It becomes 4x. It becomes 160. And likewise, you can solve for it. So at 40 degrees Celsius, or you can say at 40 degree Fahrenheit, it comes out to be the same. If you need to convert degree Celsius into Kelvin, then how you will be doing it? You will be adding, like 2 degree Celsius, you will be adding 273. Suppose if I give you a temperature 100 degrees Celsius and I ask you to convert into Kelvin, just add 273. So it becomes 373 Kelvin. And likewise, if I give you 373 Kelvin and I ask you to convert into degree Celsius, just subtract 273. So that means it comes out to be 100 degree Celsius. So that means temperature are actually interconvertible.